Hello, my name is Sean Castile. I'm the Extension Soybean Agronomist here at Purdue University. Today we're going to be talking about scouting soybean fields for nutritional needs. We can go through the proper tissue sampling procedures for that most recent mature leaf, and if it's on a schedule of doing vegetative stages or early reproductive stages like the field we're in today, that's one thing. There's another option out there with tools to kind of help you diagnose or look at areas of the field that maybe you wouldn't have otherwise. So a UAV coming over your field, taking images and stitching those together, or a plane or fixed wing that has an NDVI characteristic to it. You look across this field and may seem fairly uniform, at least in greenness, but you might pull out a spot in the field that looks a little that yellowish color on an NDVI map instead of an actual RGB or a typical just actual plants themselves. So we're going to talk about how to actually take those samples. So as you go out to take tissue samples for soybeans, at this point we're looking at the most recent mature leaf. And what that really means is the most recent fully expanded leaf. So as you come into this canopy, we're going to come down and find the upper portion. So the proper leaf is going to be between the third and fourth trifoliate. And what I mean by that is when you start looking at the leaf size, does it really get any bigger or not? I'll go down and look at number two. Number two, we'll just pull the center leaf to make it a little easier in comparison to number one. Certainly we can talk about those are certainly different. We have very small. Next one, let me put that over and go down to number three. Number three, we'll just take the center leaflet in comparison. So at this point, the number three is a little bit bigger, and you'll also notice a darker green color to it. Number two, in my left hand now, has that kind of sheen to it. It also has a little thinner leaf to it, so it's not quite fully developed. And I'll go down to number four. Again, I'll just take the center in comparison. So when you start comparing these, and we'll look at them on the tailgate, obviously with number three is a little bit longer, but number four has that same dark green color. So in this case, that's usually between that third and fourth trifoliate is going to be the most appropriate. If we go back, let me kind of stack them in reverse. If this number one trifoliate was smaller, probably more like the size of a quarter, but just expanding, would be more likely to go to the number four position instead of the number three. If you talk with this terminal here, the leaf margins are not touching, but it's still a little rolled up, but they're not touching. If you count that as number one, it's smaller than that quarter size or so. So if that would be one, two, number three, and number four. So this would be the proper leaf to sample, number four. If you're counting, I'm going to wait till they're a little more expanded, each to their own. This year is your first one, so that's certainly bigger than that half dollar. That would be one, two, and three. Now all of a sudden, you're still taking the very same sample. It's just a matter of where's your starting block. You're talking a small trifoliate you're counting first, or one that's a little more expanded. Regardless, if you use kind of those rough guidelines of small quarter type size or larger than a half dollar, you end up at that same point taking this leaf here. You have one, two, three leaves for the trifoliate. That's one of the 20 to 25 samples we'll take. Notice the petiole that's still attached. You can leave it there or you can pull it off. Most cases, I still just grab it all. What you do not need is this full petiole. One, two, three. I'm gonna go to the fourth one on this one again. That first terminal was a bit small, so that's my second sample. So we'll keep on going. So one, two, three. This time I'm doing position three. The first trifoliate was more expanded than the last set. Again, that's probably more like a half dollar, even a little bit bigger. Now, as you go across the field and you're trying to get an idea, do I need to do any foliar feeding or do I have any nutritional issues? So again, counting through, one, two, three, and that one looks great. Coming across, just bear in mind if you've already taken some samples or already sprayed, Usually you want to wait about 10 to 14 days after a foliar spray to make sure that it's worked through the system, as well as you don't have any residue that's on that leaf that could potentially contaminate and overscore that nutrient analysis. With that in mind, if you're 10 to 14 days, you're also allowing that time, that plant time, to grow new leaves. So I'm going to count down again and get my, in this case, my fourth one. And you're growing at this point with these early reproductive stages, we're in R3, you're growing about a set of leaves, a trifoliate, every 4 days, give or take, if you've got good growing conditions. So that 10 to 14 days, you've already put on another 3 to 4 leaves since that application or since you took that last sample. So if you're going to do these snapshots over time, you know, give it a little time. Don't just do it every week, but give it a little time for new growth to come in to see how that plant's responding to the soil conditions as well as anything that you've applied. As you've taken your 20 to 25 leaves, trifoliate leaves, go and put them in your brown bag just like you did your lunch as a kid. Let it air dry or send it overnight the next day to your lab. Write your field down, date, and make sure you put the growth stage. These nutritional analyses will change based on your growth stage. An earlier vegetative period is going to be totally different than the R3 samples we just took.